hit alpha and then F4, parentheses, and then 0.25. So this is the same as F of 0.25. Dear Calculus 2 students, I would like to show you the easiest way to do the midpoint rule, trapezoidal rule, and the Simpson's rule problem. Let's say this is the integral that we want to approximate, and we have n is equal to 4. First, we are going to compute delta x, and that's just b minus a, so that's 2 minus 0, over the n value, which is just 1 half, and we can use decimal, that's just 0.5. Next, you really don't have to graph this function, but pay attention to the interval, and draw a number line for that. Let's say we have 0 to 2 like this, and the delta x tells us each time we go up, we will go up by 0.5. So start at 0, go up, we will get 0.5, and then do it again, we get 1, do it again, we get 1.5. These right here will be the x values that we have to use for the trapezoidal rule and the Simpson's rule. For the midpoint, of course, we will have to get the midpoint between this and that. It's just 0.25. And you can just add up these two numbers and then divide it by 2 if like the number is a little bit more complicated. By the way, this plus that divided by 2, you get 0.75. And the middle here is 1.25. And the middle right here is 1.75. And lastly, this right here is of course our function. So let me just denote that f of x is equal to square root of 1 plus x to the third power. Now, we are ready to go. Midpoint rule with n equals 4. That's the notation. First, we have delta x all the way in the front. So that's just 0.5. And then parentheses. Now, for midpoint rule, the coefficients of the function will be just 1. First, we will have f. And then, we are going to plug in this for the x value. So that's 0.25. And then, do it again, coefficient right here is just 1, f of the next x value is 0.75, and then do it again, f of next x value 1.25, and then lastly, f of 1.75. And guess what, you're done. Of course, this is just a setup, but if you have this on my test, you'll pretty much have most of the credits on that question. Okay, let's go ahead and do the trapezoidal rule. T4. First, we will have delta x divided by 2, right? And then here, the first coefficient and the last coefficient will be 1. Anything between will be 2. So right here, we will have 1 f of, remember for the trapezoidal rule and also Simpson's rule, we are using these numbers for the x values. So we will have 0. And then next one, we will have the coefficient 2 times f of the next x value, which is 0.5. Continue, 2 times f of the next x value, and then plus 2 times f of the next x value. And then lastly, the coefficient is 1, because this is the last x value. So it's just f of 2. Guess what, we're done. All right, Simpson's rule, S4. For Simpson's rule, we will have 0.5 divided by 3. One way to remember is that you have delta x divided by 1, trapezoidal rule is delta divided by 2, and then this right here is divided by 3. Yeah. Okay, Simpson's rule and trapezoidal rule are pretty similar. The first coefficient is 1, likewise the last coefficient will also be 1, but in the middle, we will have 4, 2, 4, 2. Yeah, it alternates. And in order for us to use the Simpson's rule, n must be even. So first, we will have f of 0, right? This is the x value that we use. Next, we start with 4. 4 times f of the next x value, which is 0.5. And then it alternates to become 2 right here. F of the next x value. And then you change that to 4 again. And then f of the next x value. And this is the last one. So the coefficient right here is just 1. So we just add f of 2. And guess what? You're done. Seriously. Now, of course, we have to get the question right. Let's go ahead and see how we can use a calculator to compute these things. First, let's go to y equals and then enter this function to y1. So we have square root of 1 plus x to the third power. We don't have to grab this, just go back to the main page, and then we will enter this expression for m4. So first we have 0.5 and then parentheses. Now for f of 0.25. I would like to thank Michelle for showing me this. So thank you so much. Earlier we entered this function to y1, right? So check this out. Hit alpha and then f4. That's how you can call out the y1. And then let's use the function notation. So parentheses and then 0.25. So this is the same as f of 0.25. And then we just continue for the rest. So we add alpha f4 and then y1, and then we have parentheses and then 0.75, just like this. And then we have two more to go, and then just add alpha f4 and then y1 and then 1.25, and then we add alpha and then y1 and then parentheses 1.75, close parentheses, and then there you have it. This is the answer for M4. Now let's do the next one, T4.
0.5 divided by 2 and then parentheses. Here we have f of 0, so alpha f4 and then y1 and then just enter the 0 and then plus 2 and then alpha and then y1 and then 0.5 plus 2 alpha f4 y1 and then we have 1 and then plus 2 alpha f4 y1 and then 1.5, and lastly just add alpha f4 y1 and then parentheses 2 like this.
And this is the answer for T4. And now for S4, notice how this and that are pretty similar, right? So I will just hit second and then enter. So this can call out the expression I wrote down earlier. And then I just have to change some values, right? So go back. So the over 2 becomes the over 3. And then the coefficient match. And this 2 should be a 4. And then this 2 is okay. And then this right here should be a 4. So Y1, 1.5. So just like that. And then just press enter. And then we're done. And because this function is differentiable on the interval from 0 to 2, then we know for sure that Simpson's rule is the best. And the next one is the midpoint rule. And the trapezoidal rule is the worst for among the three. And now as a bonus, I will show you how we can evaluate this integral on the calculator. Just go to math. And then go down to number 9, FNINT. So we have 0 to 2. And then here we enter square root of 1 plus x to the third power. And you also have to make sure that you go out right here and then use this right here for x. So just x. You have to have the dx. And then enter. You see how the Simpson's rule and the integral value is very close. And then the next one is the midpoint rule, which is the top one. Anyway though, hopefully this right here helps. Best of luck for your Calc 2 class.